Well, this review is late. There can't be help. Actually, nothing of this can help anymore. But what I do really do not like is that why do you keep on doing this? Why are fairy tale being crushed by these imbeciles that are supposed to be not us, not on their level? It is excruciating to see such despair. Yes, this is the Fairy Tale 100 Years Quest, Chapter 36, and easiest way to summarize it, despite Mara Jane being Mara Jane, well, she apparently cannot combat Skaldrium. And I think that is just meant to be the word for bait, but stop it, stop it. Just for the love of all dragons, stop it! This is not meant to be the Wolf Effect. This is meant to be Fairy Tale crushing these arrogant assholes. That is the shtick. It's always been the shtick. Also, Lysana survives and has now transformed into a Lamia. Was that the word? You know, a snake woman. Snake under hat and lady top. She reels up around in Lucy. In a way that is called Animal Soul Snake. It's kind of a, well, I want to say erotic things. It's the fact that she whirls herself around Lucy, is about to snuff out and then say, look into my eyes and be dyed white. Let's be white together. You know, in a way that almost sounds like, you know, an erotic moment, which is kind of out of character for someone like Lysana. Granted, this is her, she was brainwashed. But is this meant to say that is she's secretly bisexual or else? Who knows? Either way, Kyria also fights the rest, but and while it does cut it up, it still seems she hasn't defeated else. Also, Ersa gets caught by the binding snake, and Jalal just decides to book it after that. You know, it's a very comedic moment, but also a little bit of a moment like, oh my god. But again, Jalal is so brainwashed, he is acting on his impulses. I think he's pretty embarrassed if he ever did what he did. So yeah, he just Luxas vs. Kyria. It makes me glad that Luxas hasn't been knocked out yet. But given the standard that it always seems that Diabolus is supposed to be the most ultimate powerful and Fairy Tail is supposed to be weak in this manga, it's only a matter of time before that happens. Also, Natsu faces off against Wraith, who, of course, defeats him, as always is possible. Because, again, for some reason, Fairy Tail have to be nullified. They are supposed to do nothing against these Dragon Eaters. Calm the freak on! They are the main characters. They are not supposed to lose. Either way, it seems that the Wraith, the Ghost, is only visible to Dragon Slayers and joined Diabolus in order to find the man who stole his life. While that doesn't know what has happened, I don't know. He uses his dragon spirit to pull Natsu's soul out of his body, so to speak. And again, that is a very upsetting. Why do you keep on doing this to the same guy that defeated Acnologia and Seraph of all people? It's excruciating, to be perfectly honest. But something tells me that Wraith cannot eat Natsu's soul. First of all, because Natsu's a main character and that's plot armor, but also most likely more... remember, Natsu's second soul was that of END, even though his soul has been cured of the END references. He entered a berserker mode when Ignea gave him power. So something tells me maybe the soul of is too much for Wraith to eat. Either way, for some reason, Wraith is a ghost that has been killed by someone and joining Diabolus to hunt that man down. Why do I have a feeling that man is someone we already knew? Either way, not exactly the most satisfying of chapters here. I mean, because, again, I despise to see Fairy Tail being so nullified. The Lysana-Lucia scene, yeah, that was sexy, but it was also a little bit inappropriate. I mean, sexiness is never inappropriate, but it's more of the fact that Lisanna has never shown this before. So why did she do it now? Is that the same of Yelal? Now that she's white, she's urging up her most little, you know, standard animal urges, or is it something else? Ah, who cares? It's better not to find out anyway. Just go with the flow. So give me thoughts if you have any.